Nephrotic syndrome. What is that? I'm Dr. Frida. I'm a board certified kidney specialist, and I'll tell you exactly what it is. Nephrotic syndrome is a kidney disorder where you leak out excessive amounts of protein through your urine, and it can lead to all kinds of complications. It can lead to swollen feet, ankles, legs, swollen hands, a swollen belly. It can cause swelling around the eyes. It can lead to high blood pressure, high cholesterol, blood clots, and yes, it can even cause kidney failure. Nephrotic syndrome can be bad news for both adults and children, so it's very important that you understand exactly what it is. You don't know what it is, do you? Well, don't worry, because today I'm going to break it down. I'm going to explain nephrotic syndrome, the signs, the symptoms, the treatments, and the causes you should know. Keep watching. Ever felt overlooked or not heard in a doctor's office? Frustrated with waiting rooms and rushed consultations? I'm Dr. Frida, and I have the perfect remedy. I'm a medical doctor who has been triple board certified, and I believe everyone should have access to world-class healthcare. I want to personally invite you to experience my VIP consultation telehealth services. Click the link below and book your VIP consultation today. I'm Dr. Freda. I'm a board certified nephrologist, which means I'm an MD who specializes in kidney disease and high blood pressure. And today we're talking nephrotic syndrome. Nephrotic syndrome is a rare kidney disorder, but when it hits hard. It can lead to multiple complications, including kidney failure, and it can affect both adults and children. So it's really important that you understand what it is. So this is what it is. If you think about your kidneys, you have these two bean-shaped organs located in your lower back in the flanks where the love handles are. Each kidney has 1 million glomeruli or 1 million nephrons. And what these are the filtering system of the kidney. So each glomerulus, each of the filtering units, is responsible for essentially cleaning out the blood. You have these tiny capillaries which allow blood to flow through them, and it filters out excess water and tiny particles and waste. But in a normal kidney, these glomeruli, these kidney functioning units, will hold on to bigger particles like red blood cells, white blood cells, and protein. Well, in nephrotic syndrome, there is a problem with the way that these nephrons filter. And instead of holding on to protein in the blood, they filter out protein and allow the protein to get into the urine. And this is what leads to the problems. When you have excess protein in the urine, it leads to multiple complications, including edema, high blood pressure, high cholesterol, and even kidney failure. And I'll break it down and explain exactly how. So let's start with edema, which is swelling. It's a swelling that can occur in the feet, the ankles, the legs, the hands. It can occur in the whole body. You can get periorbital edema or swelling around the eyes. And this is how it happens. So your albumin, which is that protein that's leaking out excessively in the kidneys with nephrotic syndrome, well, that protein acts like a sponge when it's inside of your vessels. And it helps to keep fluid inside of the blood vessels where it belongs. Well, when you urinate out excess protein, like you do in nephrotic syndrome, you lose that sponge, and so you also lose the ability to keep fluid within the blood vessels. So what happens? That fluid leaks out into the tissues, and that's when you get that swelling, okay? The swelling all over the body. It's because the protein is low. Beyond the swelling just being uncomfortable, it can also lead to issues like ascites or excess fluid in the belly. It can lead to excess fluid in the lungs and cause shortness of breath as well. Edema is not the only complication from losing this excess protein in the urine with nephrotic syndrome. You can also get high cholesterol. Oh, high cholesterol, what sense does that make? Well, I'll tell you. Your liver is responsible for making the albumin, okay? It makes that protein. So when the liver senses that you've lost too much protein, well, you get low levels of protein in the blood, right? And what does the liver do in response? Well, it decides it's going to pump out more protein, right? Pump out more albumin. Well, in pumping out that protein, it also pumps out certain proteins that are associated with cholesterol, like LDL. And when it pumps out those proteins, it can lead to excess cholesterol. So as part of the responsiveness of the liver in trying to produce more albumin, it actually produces more cholesterol. And so nephrotic syndrome can lead to high cholesterol or dyslipidemia, which of course can lead to other complications like heart disease, strokes, and things of that nature. Be sure to watch my video on how to lower cholesterol naturally after you finish watching this video. Another complication of nephrotic syndrome is hypertension. Now, how is that related? I'll tell you. So I mentioned that albumin, that protein, is like a sponge that's supposed to keep fluid inside the vessels, right? So with the nephrotic syndrome, you've urinated out excess protein, and now you no longer have that sponge, and your blood vessels don't have as much fluid. So what happens is when the kidneys are censoring the fluid that's flowing through their vessels, flowing through those capillaries, flowing through those glomeruli, right, those filtering units, well, you have a decreased amount of blood volume, right? You have decreased fluid in the vessels. And so in response to that, the renin-angiotensin system is activated. And what that means is that the kidneys feel like if you don't have enough fluid, then the pressure is too low. And so they try to make the pressure higher. And so they activate certain mechanisms that cause you to hold on to salt, cause your blood vessels to tighten, and it can lead to high blood pressure. So with this nephrotic syndrome, one of the responses is that you get an elevated blood pressure or hypertension. Another complication of nephrotic syndrome is blood clots. Yes, yes, it's another complication that is related directly to losing too much protein through the urine. I'll explain. One of the proteins that you lose with nephrotic syndrome, one of the proteins that leaks out in the urine, is something called antithrombin 3. Now, typically, antithrombin 3 is a protein that will help to maintain proper clotting in your body, okay? It'll help to keep you from being hypercoagulable, meaning it'll keep your blood from clotting too much. Well, in nephrotic syndrome, you're losing all of these proteins through the urine, including antithrombin 3, and so you lose your ability to keep the blood from clotting too much. So what happens? You can get blood clots. You can get deep venous thrombi, okay? Or you can even get renal vein thrombosis. So basically, nephrotic syndrome can lead to a hypercoagulable state leading to blood clots. And we know that some of these blood clots can even go to the lungs causing pulmonary emboli. It's a problem. Be sure to watch my video on blood clots and DVTs after you finish watching this video. Another complication of nephrotic syndrome is kidney failure. With this disruption in the glomeruli, the filtering units of the kidney, it can ultimately lead to the kidneys not filtering anything properly, leading to end-stage renal disease requiring dialysis or a kidney transplant. Nephrotic syndrome is pretty rare, but it can affect both adults and children. According to the NIH, the incidence of nephrotic syndrome in children is 1 to 2 cases per 100,000 children 16 years of age and younger. And in adults, it's 3 cases per 100,000 adults. Now, I've explained that nephrotic syndrome is when you have excessive amounts of protein in the urine. And some of you listening may be thinking, I've gone to my doctor, I've had my urine dipstick, and they told me that I had some protein. Maybe I have nephrotic syndrome. Well, there's a very specific way that we quantify how much protein is too much protein and how much protein we consider to be nephrotic syndrome. Nephrotic syndrome is when you urinate out 3.5 grams of protein or more in your urine in 24 hours. That's 3,500 milligrams of protein that you're excreting each day. That's a lot of protein. It's normal to have essentially no protein in your urine, or certainly less than 300 milligrams. Question, have you or someone you know been affected by nephrotic syndrome? Please share your experience down below. I would love to hear about it. Now, let's talk about some of the causes of nephrotic syndrome. Now, very often, nephrotic syndrome is idiopathic, meaning we don't know where it came from. We don't know why it started. But there are some identifiable causes of nephrotic syndrome as well, and we'll get into those. In children, the most common cause is minimal change disease. And this is when kids, again, excrete a whole lot of protein in the urine, and they get puffy faces, they get swelling everywhere, and they get some of the complications we talked about. The good news that in children with most cases of minimal change disease, steroids are the treatment and it does not progress to kidney failure. Now, for adults, the most common cause of nephrotic range proteinuria or nephrotic syndrome is diabetes. Oh my goodness, diabetes shows up everywhere. Yeah, having diabetic nephropathy or diabetic kidney disease can cause you to leak out more than 3.5 grams of protein in 24 hours, and it can lead to nephrotic syndrome. Another cause of nephrotic syndrome is lupus, systemic lupus erythematosus. It can certainly lead to nephrotic range proteinuria. Also, HIV. Yeah, you can get HIV-associated nephropathy. FSG, or focal segmental glomerulosclerosis, which is the most common cause of glomerulonephritis or inflammation of the glomeruli in people of African descent. It can lead to nephrotic syndrome. Other diseases that can do it include hepatitis, membranous nephropathy. And membranous is something because there are all kinds of causes of membranous nephropathy. One can be cancer or chronic inflammation. Lupus can lead to membranous nephropathy as well. Amyloidosis is another condition that can lead to nephrotic syndrome. Certain medications can do it, like penicillamine and gold. Yeah. So now, here are the top warning signs and symptoms of nephrotic syndrome. Protein in the urine, which can show up as foamy urine. And I don't mean just a couple of little bubbles when you urinate. I'm talking about foam. So like if you've seen those beer commercials where they're pouring beer out of the tap and it's all that white foam on top, a lot of foam in the urine can indicate that you have protein and you definitely want to get that checked. Another sign can be a surge in blood pressure. And remember, high blood pressure is defined as a systolic blood pressure of 130 or greater, or a diastolic blood pressure of 80 or greater. If you're getting surges in your blood pressure, that could be a sign of nephrotic syndrome. We talked about swelling. If you're waking up with periorbital edema or that swelling around your eyes, so if you notice that your abdomen is poofing out, you're getting puffy hands, puffy feet, your shoes and socks are getting tight, this is edema. So that can be another sign of nephrotic syndrome. Also, high cholesterol levels. If you go to the doctor and all of a sudden your LDL is sky high, you've got high triglycerides. If you're getting blood clots, you want to think about it. So like if you get pain, swelling, redness in a leg, especially behind the knee, like behind that kneecap, that could be a sign of a DVT, a deep venous thrombosis, which could be caused by nephrotic syndrome. Or if you get severe flank pain or like kidney pain radiating to the groin. Now, there are lots of things that can cause it. And certainly if you're getting some blood in the urine, but a possibility, especially if you're already thinking nephrotic syndrome, that could be a sign of renal vein thrombosis. Be sure to watch my video on causes of kidney pain symptoms after you finish watching this video. Do any of the causes of nephrotic syndrome that I mentioned surprise you? Please comment down below. So now let's talk about how to identify early signs of nephrotic syndrome, because you really don't want to wait and sit around until you have some catastrophic complication, right? Well, the best thing to do is to see your doctor regularly, because when you see your doctor, there are certain screening tests that are done that could pick up some of the signs. For example, when you have your routine histories and physicals, they always check your blood sugar or your glucose levels. Sometimes they check your hemoglobin A1C. If you're having elevated glucose, or if you're having an elevated hemoglobin A1C that indicates prediabetes or diabetes, well, remember, diabetes is the number one cause of nephrotic range proteinuria. That could be a way to pick up an early sign that you could be at risk for developing nephrotic syndrome. Also, when your doctors check your urine, they often do a urinalysis, which will let them know if you have protein, or they'll do one of those urine dipsticks to see if you have protein. If you have a lot of protein, like 3+, well, then there are further evaluations that can be done to quantify the urine, such as a 24-hour urine for protein. But an early sign could be a high amount of protein on that urine dipstick or in the urinalysis. Another early sign, cholesterol. Yes, and cholesterol for adults is a routine test that's done. If you have hypercholesterolemia, that could be a warning sign and that could trigger your doctor to check for other potential signs of nephrotic syndrome to pick it up early. And certainly when your physician examines you, they'll be able to see if you have edema. They can press down on your shins to see if they leave their fingerprints, or if you have pitting edema. And they can just examine you, and you can examine yourself. You can look in the mirror. You know if you have swelling around your eyes or excess swelling in your belly, that could be another early sign. Now I want to briefly touch on the difference between nephrotic versus nephritic syndromes, because it can be confusing, right? We've already established that nephrotic syndrome is when there's an abnormality in the way that the kidneys filter out protein, right? You get excessive protein in the urine. Well, with nephritic syndrome, there's an abnormality with the way that the kidneys filter out red blood cells, among other things. And so you literally get red blood cells and blood in the urine. With nephritic syndrome, you can have a dark colored urine, tea colored, or outright bloody urine. You can also get swelling around the eyes, periorbital edema, or some other swelling. The swelling tends to be greater in nephrotic syndrome, but you certainly can also get swelling in nephritic syndrome. You can also get hypertension in nephritic syndrome. That's an overlap. But the main difference is that nephrotic syndrome, the issue is filtering out too much protein. Nephritic syndrome, the issue is filtering out too much blood and some other toxins as well. What questions do you have about nephrotic versus nephritic syndrome? Please put them in the comment section down below, and your question may be featured in one of my future videos. As far as the treatment for nephrotic syndrome, yeah, we're moving back to nephrotic syndrome. Well, that's going to vary, right? It's going to depend on what the cause is. Now, I already mentioned that for minimal change disease, which is the one that's common in children, usually it's steroid sensitive, and so steroids are going to be the treatment. Well, steroids can treat some of the other causes of nephrotic syndrome as well, like FSG or focal segmental glomerular sclerosis. But then if diabetes is the cause, well, the treatment is going to be to treat the underlying diabetes. So it could be with lifestyle modifications, right? Having a low carb diet, high protein, and avoiding added sugar. It could be with medications as far as the diabetes, like insulin, semaglutide, tirzepatide, metformin. It depends if diabetes is the cause. If lupus is the cause, then it could also be steroids as a treatment. It could also be medications like mycophenolate or hydroxychloroquine. If the cause is HIV, the treatment will be antiretroviral medications. If the cause is hepatitis, again, antiviral medications. But again, understanding that diabetes is the number one cause of nephrotic range protein, you really should focus on prevention, because if you're able to prevent developing diabetes, or certainly if you can manage it, that is one huge way to decrease your risk of developing nephrotic syndrome. Nephrotic syndrome is a bit of a complex topic, and it's not exactly your everyday dinner conversation, but hopefully now you have a better understanding. If you found this video to be helpful and informative, please like it and share it with the people you care about. If you would like to discuss this or other medical topics further, one-on-one with me, or if you would like a comprehensive history and physical and a consultation, I now offer a concierge service. This way, you get a one-on-one conversation with me where I can talk to you about your own specific history and give you my medical advice. You will have my undivided attention, and you'll really get a chance to get your medical questions answered by me personally. Please remember, in everything that you do health-wise, it's important to consult your physician. You want to make sure that you see your doctor regularly so that you can have preventive checkups and so that you can potentially prevent things like nephrotic syndrome, or certainly treat them or slow the progression. I appreciate your support and for spending this time with me. And as always, I want you to do your best to live your healthiest, happiest life. I'm Dr. Frita.